Welcome back to the Lean Discovery Applied series. I'm Clinton Sanko with my guest, Ian Campbell, President and CEO of iCONECT. I want to take a bit of a detour into information governance land for a minute as we talk through this. And that obviously, for somebody that's been in the industry as long as you, that's been a topic of conversation almost as long as I can frankly remember. In a video interview that you did in 2018, you were talking about information governance in the specific context of when an employee leaves the company and the data that they're stranding, their email account, their smartphone, their file share that may live on a network, and how companies were dealing with that from a business intelligence, compliance, and also, obviously, if anything were to come up in terms of litigation later in your casino context fits in that as well. As we sit here in 2020, what are you seeing as the key compliance issues that corporations are needing help in attacking and managing, particularly as it relates to information governance and outside the e-discovery context?
Yeah, it's interesting. There's a lot of acronyms out there for that now. You know, you got DSAR, GDPR, CCPA, you've got, you know, and kind of everything in between. So I think IG or information governance is sort of an umbrella that sits on top of a lot of different things. I think one of the challenges that corporations have is that they have a lot of data. We're actually involved in a project right now. This firm has over 200,000 employees, and they have every email ever sent or received ever by every employee ever. And so they're well over 2 billion on the number of emails they have. They've never really adopted a data retention policy. And I think a lot of firms, perhaps to a smaller scale, are running into the issue. They don't know what they don't know, and they don't know what they have. And some of that's dangerous, especially with GDPR and some of the stuff happening in the European Union. And it's all moving in this direction. And I think in five years from now, it's going to be even bigger. 5 years from 5 years ago, we kind of knew it was there, but it wasn't really accumulating at the same exponential rate that it is now. But now it's just becoming overwhelming for folks. And I think we're seeing more and more. Iron Mountain uses a term in some of their marketing material called a data lake. I think it's a great term, because imagine, if you will, you've got stuff in SharePoint, stuff in Exchange Server, stuff in Office 365, stuff in Dropbox. It's just a big lake of data, and not all of it's relevant. Some of it's just kind of stuff. But if you get sued for the elevators in Terminal 3 from that construction job that was done in 2011, you got a pretty good idea what you're looking for. 2011, these five engineers, anything in Terminal 3, anything related to any of these four or five contractors, go. And if you can go and scan all that information and go and bring back only, not the 2 billion, but only the 15,000 documents that meet those search criteria, drop that into the iConnect platform and now do your project, that's very, very valuable for people. And I think, I think on sort of on two fronts, I think that way of looking at the world, that you don't have to scan everything, you don't have to make everything readily available, and you don't have to hold on to everything. I mean, I think everyone on the call today would realize that, you know, things have a life, and if you can show a defensible retention policy that you've always gotten rid of stuff after 5 years, or you've always gotten rid of stuff out of 4 years, and nobody's ever going to come along and go, hey, why didn't you keep that from 12 years ago? So I think there's more and more defenses coming up around that. But the other area in information governance is the privacy issue. And I think more and more we're seeing and going to continue to see the identification of personal information in documents. You talk about all those documents that come in from all those diverse data points, and now you've got the 30,000. First thing you should probably do in that 30,000 is figure out what you got. Are there any Visa cards in it? Are there any driver's license numbers? Are there any insurance information? Is there any, are there any dates? Are there any city names? I mean, different things that at some point in time might cause a hiccup. And we've got some unique technology to be able to help siphon through that inbound data and sort of organize it and identify anything that might be a problem, so you can decide what to do with it. And I think that's key, is being able to control that data in a world where it's in some cases it's very uncontrolled.